doing lab scale experiments at high temperatures, it's not very easy. It means actually that you have to have a good expertise within these kind of experiments. The SIO test is very important for the industry, first of all, and the main point is that it's really vital for the silicon producers to actually be able to produce silicon. They need to know something about the carbon material. The point is that you need high temperatures to produce the SiO gas, and that is actually a very difficult part of the process. So you need a very controlled determination of what kind of gas you are producing and then how it reacts with the carbon material.
For the SiO reactivity test that was developed by SINTEF around 1968, and it's unique, it's the only one in the world that is doing this as a standardized test. So it's used all over the world. We get samples from carbon producers in Russia, Colombia, and also from the silicon producers in a lot of different countries. In the silicon process, you get some SiO gas, and that has to be captured. And it is captured by the carbon. How fast the carbon captures it, we measure as the SiO reactivity. If it's not captured, it will go out as a loss. You will get more waste, higher energy consumptions, and you will get less silicon produced. For the silicon industry, to know the SiO reactivity has been one of the most important tools to develop the efficiency of the process.
I think the interaction between the industry in Norway and SINTEF and NTNU is very strong. So we can always customize the tests that the industry needs. So this cooperation has kind of led us in advance in research generally, but also regarding the SiO test.
It will be very difficult to develop new carbon materials and non-fossil carbon reductant without having a tool like this.